Justice Oliver Wendell Holmes is almost certainly one of the greatest minds of American law. It's difficult to reconcile the great man Holmes with this terrible and awful judgment. Eugenics is the philosophy of attempting to improve the human race by breeding out undesirable characteristics, by preventing those with undesirable characteristics from reproducing. It was an especially popular theory in Nazi Germany, underlying the policy of Aryan racial purity. In 1927, while a young Adolf Hitler was preparing to contest the Reichstag elections, the question of eugenics came before the US Supreme Court. Ms. Carrie Buck was a woman of apparently average intelligence, whose mother had been committed to an institution for the feeble-minded, on the allegation that she was immoral and a prostitute. There is no evidence that either Carrie Buck or her mother had any form of intellectual impairment. When she was 18, Carrie Buck was raped by the nephew of her foster parents. To avoid responsibility, her foster parents had her committed to an institution for the epileptic and feeble-minded on grounds of promiscuity and incorrigibility. The state of Virginia had passed the Eugenical Sterilisation Act, under which those declared to be feeble-minded could be sterilised by the removal of fallopian tubes in the case of women. It was proposed to perform this operation upon Carrie Buck against her will. The Supreme Court was called upon to consider whether the Virginia law was contrary to the 14th Amendment guarantee that no state shall deprive any person of life, liberty, or property without due process of law. Justice Holmes wrote the decision. He noted the lower court finding that Carrie Buck is the probable potential parent of socially inadequate offspring, likewise afflicted, that she may be sexually sterilized without detriment to her general health, and that her welfare and that of society will be promoted by her sterilization. He then wrote, "It is better for all the world if, instead of waiting to execute degenerate offspring for crime, or to let them starve for their imbecility, society can prevent those who are manifestly unfit from continuing their kind. Three generations of imbeciles is enough." Ms. Buck was sterilized and released. Her child, Vivian, died from complications from measles, aged 6. Ms. Buck, not feeble-minded, lived a normal life, marrying twice and dying at age 76 in 1983. This case has never been overturned.